is on the move. Raptors hover over a withered carcass. But there is scent of fresher meat in the wind. Pickings have been slim for Nabumba's pride since her fight with a startled warthog. The lioness is limping from the encounter. And even the pride's big male, Jabu, wonders when his next meal will come. There's been no kill for 3 days, and Nabumba's cubs are hungry. Survival is tough across this tawny continent. And for the lions of Pinda Reserve, etched into the heart of Zululand, only those with speed and cunning will eat. For this pride anyway, it's been a long time between meals. Had waited too long for his lioness to feed him. Overnight, his stealth carried him into the path of a careless zebra. The rest of the herd is still skittish. One animal had already lost his tail to a hungry pride, but for the dazed stallion, it was all over in seconds. The big male watches his kill from a distance, exhausted by the chase, exhilarated by the sport. Jabu will feast later. Tired from the hunt, he needs to rest. But his prey will be safe. Few scavengers will risk the sudden return of the Lion King. Spore of Nabumba's pride across Nziki Marsh. This vast tract of savannah is favoured by the lions in the dry air of winter, but it's a region also shared by Pinda's giraffe and white rhino population. Through modern times, most of southern Africa's wildlife has been ravaged by hunting and habitat loss. Farmland, overgrazed and buffeted by domestic stock, has ripped the heart out of the original bush. The open, broad-leaved woodland, acacia bushveld, and wetland habitat had all but disappeared, taking with it the wildlife. A few years ago, the Pinda Project was born. 17,000 hectares of farmland bought up in KwaZulu-Natal along South Africa's eastern seaboard. What followed was the largest game restocking program ever seen on the subcontinent.
The land was overgrazed to a certain extent and it wasn't in very good shape. They put all these farms together, put a perimeter fence around it, and then brought in a lot of game. I mean, we brought in elephant, we brought in rhino. We started off with those sort of animals and then started with cheetah, bringing in cheetah onto the reserve, mainly to get them used to the area before the lions came on, because the lion is a more superior predator as such and would dominate the cheetahs. We wanted to get them settled first before the lions came in.
Andrew Lewis is habitat manager at Pinda, one of those committed to the restoration of Southern Africa's ecosystem. Pinda is the Zulu word for return, and the aim of his company, Conservation Corporation Africa, is to return the land to its traditional wildlife and at the same time restore the habitat to its original state. Pinda is cautiously open to top-level tourism, limited and luxurious. Dreams of extending the green frontier require funds, and the reserve's lion pride has already earned its keep.
The lions on this property are actually generating revenue for the property through ecotourism, and that they are a benefit to the wildlife because of the draw card. And a few animals, lions, elephants, for example, and rhinos, I mean, and possibly giraffes, but those are your main ones that people come to see. And we've been very fortunate to be able to have lions on the property, and I think those lions that we have and have given us amazing value for our guests, and by getting a guest in here, we're getting revenue into the area, and that's benefiting wildlife as a whole.
Jabu has returned to his kill. He licks the bloated carcass, but still there is no feeding. Lions will gloat over their prey, delaying the first bite until the meat ripens. For Jabu, the prospect of the meal is to be relished as much as the eventual feast. Meanwhile, Nabumbo's pride is on the prowl. The older cubs are 10 months now, weaned, but still dependent upon Nabumbo for food. The cubs are learning to stalk, but they won't kill for another 6 months. Young male lions are usually ejected from the pride when they are about 2 years old. Fending for themselves, they form hunting groups with other isolated males. Nabumbo's cubs aren't sure what to do with prey so close. But the lioness isn't far behind. Their time for hunting will come. Nabumbo's four-year-old daughter also lives with a pride. She is the mother of the group's youngest offspring, seven-week twins Umveli and Amana. The little cubs have been hidden since birth and now stay close within the protective circle. Thank you. has little time for his small cub. When he is older, the manna will hunt with his father, but for the moment, the big male has nothing to do with his young son. Dejected, the cub finds solace among his siblings. A young giraffe lies helpless in the grass. The animal's complicated vertebra means it is unable to rest its neck for any length of time. Lack of mobility means blood to the brain slows, leaving the animal disabled. Efforts to lift the head fail, and rather than leave the giraffe vulnerable to predators, the young bull is shot by rangers. Most big cats. They conserve energy 20 hours a day, waking only to groom and hunt. The lioness shows little sign of her injured leg, but the tusks of the warthog have torn sinew and muscle, slowing her in the pursuit of prey. Once again, Mbambo and her pride will go hungry. But the big lioness senses another kill nearby. A young giraffe slain by humans will provide meat for her cubs. Leaving the pride, Mbambo follows the scent. Left alone, the older cubs know the drill. They will wait for Nabumbo's call to take them to the kill. The day moves into shadow. The cubs are restless and a little afraid. Adult lions have few enemies, but cubs, even those 10 months old, are at the mercy of leopard and other predators. Nabumbo has reached the kill, but her daughter is there first. Even though females hunt together, rivalry for the prey is fierce. The big lioness begins the trek back for her cubs, but the youngsters have heard her call and they meet halfway. Labumbo settles herself in the long grass. The cubs are unfamiliar with her behaviour. A female will usually head the charge with any kill, splitting the hide of the victim and leading the way for the pride to eat. But there is human scent around the giraffe, and the big lioness is cautious. She watches her cubs, hidden, alert to any potential threat. The cubs are curious, confused by this new smell. The lioness moves in for a final check, but she has already made up her mind. The carcass is tainted. There are foreign traces, a dangerous ambience. Instinct tells her this is not food fit for her cubs. Disappointed, Labumbo moves away, the scent of another night stalk already in the wind. After 2 days, Jabu has returned to his kill with another younger male. 3-year-old Tembi is a son from a previous liaison with Labumbo, and the two paired up after Tembi was ousted from the pride. Pride males are lazy and will gladly let the females track down prey. But the theory that males won't hunt is a fallacy. Any hungry male will hunt for himself when no free lunch is provided by the lioness, hyenas or other predators. Smaller creatures scatter in the vicinity of the two lions. There will be no hunting for a while. Bloated after the zebra kill, both males will sleep for the next day, oblivious of their surroundings. Lions hunting in pairs or groups have a success rate of around 30% in daylight. But studies show single hunters are more successful at night. Lions are sociable cats, the only group to take part in communal hunts. Ambush is an important part of the lion's strategy. Often one pride female will round up the prey from the front, driving it towards a second lioness. As in most cases, the pride male will only get involved if he has to. Accidents involving humans are rare in southern Africa's game reserves. Our primal fear of being eaten has been well documented. But in fact, lions seldom attack if they're not provoked. At Pinda, great care is taken to limit the number of people viewing game. Emphasis is placed on causing the animal as little stress as possible.
Man isn't a part of their natural food source. They don't normally go out and hunt people. I think your lions are opportunists, though, and I certainly think that if your lion is very hungry, under stress, I don't think they'll necessarily go out to hunt you down, but if you interfere with them, they'll certainly kill you, and there's a good chance they might eat you at the same time. With all animals, it's how you treat them is what's the reaction you're going to get back from them. Certainly at Pinda, all our guides go through a training course and they're all brought up to a certain standard. There is a certain operating ethic with regards to viewing animals, and we certainly try and be as sensitive to the animals as possible.
Cradled within the arms of the Yubomba Mountains and the Indian Ocean, Pinda covers one of the most diverse regions of Africa. Here are found seven different ecosystems, from palm savanna and bush veld to rare sand forest and dense thorn bush, all restored from the pastoral belt which had swept down the east coast. Cotton, pineapple, and cattle farms once stood, lion now roam their habitat again, alongside some traditional neighbours. Pinda sees its responsibility to the region extending beyond restoration of habitat and wildlife. It provides schools and a clinic for the local Zulu community, as well as employment. In the eyes of Andrew Lewis, essential ingredients for a successful operation.
It's very important to involve the communities around your reserve because they have to benefit as well. There's no point in just taking land, get some investors to invest in it. But if you don't allow the people on the periphery of that reserve to benefit from it, you're going to have an immense problem with poaching, and they're going to cut your fences down, and you're just going to have an uphill battle.
In 1992, the Pinda lions were among the first of the big five animals to be relocated to the reserve. The original pride came from the northern province of South Africa, a vast scrubby region flanked by the ragged Drakensberg Mountains near the Mozambique border. Peter Rogers helped round up Pinda's first pride, handling the lion's capture and subsequent move south. Today, he's head vet at the Hoedspruit Research and Breeding Centre for Endangered Species, overseeing its cheetah breeding program. But it's the discovery of what's believed to be a long extinct strain of lion that has put Peter's centre on the map.
We were involved in the rescue of these circus animals that came down through Africa and were abandoned in Maputo. We were just found by an animal welfare group called Animal Defenders based in London. And they said, you know, could we just keep these animals temporary? First they mentioned tigers, and then they came back and said, well, there's six lions as well. So we said, yeah, we could hold them temporary just until they found permanent homes for them, but basically get them out of the predicament that they were and the shocking conditions that they were in Maputo and Mozambique.
When the lions arrived at the breeding centre, Their size, pale colouring, and the male's thick black belly mane put them into the category of the Cape or Barbary lion, not seen in the wild since the early 1920s. A few still exist in captivity, and a male and female were brought to South Africa from an Italian zoo for breeding purposes. But attempts to mate Arkef, the big male from the ill-fated Mozambique circus, with the Italian female are proving difficult. Arkef is overprotective, even preventing the lioness from eating when the meat truck arrives. Finally, though, Sisi makes her breakthrough.
We'll see you up in the front there, Mark. You're going to go to that sort of middle central area. Where are you going to go?
In the next enclosure, Arturo, the Italian Barbary male, is about to be sedated. His attention to his sister Cece through the fence is hampering mating efforts, and Peter Rogers is keen to move the big male. He shoots the dart into Arturo's rump. Arturo has been sterilized, but while his breeding days are finished, he'll live out his days at the center. His female companion, another Barbary from the Mozambique circus, is drawn away by the meat truck. It's 20 minutes before the anesthetic takes effect.
Need all your help at the bottom just to put him back into the cage, okay?
One, two, three.
The anaesthetic gives Peter Rogers and his team a chance to check over the 12-year-old lion. He'll spend a few weeks in this cage before being returned to his enclosure for observation.
I still want to inject him and everything, Mark. It's very exciting to be part of this project because they feel that there are perhaps not many Barbaries, if any, that are really pure, that are left even in captivity. They feel that over time. Other animals from other genetic bases are brought in. So there's a big project afoot at Oxford University to do the genetics. So that's just getting off the ground now. Okay. We just put under the skin of the neck if we can find the skin under this big pair of these. Normally lions wouldn't have this many ticks, but being from Italy, a European lion, it doesn't have that innate or inherent resistance to ticks. It does come with time. Put him in there and dry him over inside there. Immediate term now is to get these ones to breed. And we'll take it day by day from there and see how it goes. But the prime object initially was just to get these animals back into good health. And it's developed into something a lot bigger.
Yeah. While the breeding center's lions are healthy, it's not the case a few kilometers away in the Kruger National Park, where TB has ravaged half the population. Infected buffalo have been blamed for the outbreak, primarily in the south of the park. And attempts are being made to fence off the diseased area.
And the lions are preying on infected buffalo. Because it's an exotic disease, not an indigenous disease, the lions are totally naive. And they've got no resistance to it, so it's a big problem. It's a very difficult decision to make as to what to do. It's a very topical and heated subject at the moment.
In Pinder, the night stalk has begun. Nabumbo keeps her cubs close. They're hungry, but tonight only Impala can be tracked down, a morsel for the lioness. Food is scarce at this time of year, so the pride's territory covers a large area. Lions can only afford to be territorial where there is a reliable supply of game. Jabu wants to mate. He's been with this pride for nearly a year now. But Nabumbo would prefer a larger group of males around her. Eventually, though, Jabu will have to join forces with other males to have a chance of keeping this pride. The big male is only 7 years old and a fine specimen, weighing in at just under 200 kilograms. For the moment, he's secure. Although tonight, Nabumbo has hunting on her mind. The cubs follow in the lioness's wake. If there is a kill, she will feed first. Often, weak cubs lose out to a hungry mother. High juvenile mortality rates are the result of lean times. Jabu has had enough. He's been walking for hours. Sleep is more important. And the zebra he ate 2 days ago will suffice for another night. Nabumbo has made a kill, a young Nyala buck. It's been 3 days since the pride has eaten, and this will provide meat for them all. But the lioness will eat first. The cubs know the routine. They will get their turn. But Nkosi is hungry. He creeps towards his mother. As the biggest of the cub, Nkosi watches. A lioness can eat more than 20 kilograms in a single sitting. This could be a long wait for the little cub. Nkosi approaches the kill cautiously. Sometimes a lioness will turn on her cubs. But today, Nabumbo is pleased with her efforts. Nabumbo has had her fill, for the moment anyway. Lions never eat the stomach of a kill. She will bury it before dragging off the carcass. This way, hyenas and other predators are thrown off the scent. The evidence has been buried. The carcass is no more. Nabumbo's daughter hears the call. It is the second this morning. The first was the strangling cry of the Nyala as Nabumbo broke the young buck's back. There was no struggle. The big lioness is a seasoned hunter. The rest of the pride will feast on the carcass after Nabumbo retires. The first, they will drag it into the bushes, away from prying eyes, away from raptors already circling the kill scene. Even the hippo, its bad temper legendary, is flustered, anxious to protect its waterhole. Wildebeest are a favourite prey for lions. Naturally, they feel vulnerable. But for the pride, there is no agitation. Gorged, they will sleep for the next day. Even Mveli and Amana, the seven-week twins, have tasted blood for the first time. But it will be many months before they take part in a hunt. For the moment, they just want to play with Nkosi. The older cub is beginning to take on the shaggy mane of the bigger males. Within 18 months, he will be hunting with them, competing for his own pride. In the meantime, though, he has to contend with his young siblings. Jabu rejoins the pride. He has missed out on the kill, but he didn't share his zebra with the rest of the pride the previous day. A half-hearted attempt at mating, but the big lion's attention is drawn to a curious onlooker. With the pride so close, the giraffe won't be sitting for long. Drinking and sitting is when they are at their most vulnerable. Jabu keeps an eye on his group. Pride takeovers by other males are common, and savage fights can occur between the pride male and the intruder. If a takeover is successful, the new male will usually kill all the suckling young of his former rival. When a nursing mother loses her cubs, she comes into heat within a few weeks. The normal interval between cubs is about 2 years, with a gestation time of 3 to 4 months. Jabu marks his territory, but it may soon be all in vain. A fresh infusion of lion genes is necessary to avoid the effects of long-term inbreeding. It's likely Jabu and his son Tembi will be swapped for males from another game reserve. This will broaden the bloodlines of future lions and avoid the genetic risks currently facing the pride at Pinda. Vultures have found the dead buck, but there is little left of the carcass. Novemba and her pride have eaten. The big lioness tries to dislodge Inyala fur from her teeth. Tomorrow, the next day, there will be another kill. Novemba's cubs will grow up strong. The lion is the greatest of all predators, the essence of all that is Africa. And yet, there are fewer than 50,000 left in the wild. The future for the species lies in managed reserves such as Pinda. Here in Zululand, the lion roams free for the first time since the beginning of this century. At Pinda, the philosophy has always been simple. Africa's wildlife land, undervalued and underutilized, is the continent's most precious natural resource. Focusing on the animals, their habitat and local communities is just the beginning of an African renaissance. Pinda is, after all, the Zulu word for return. Maybe too, it's a chance for man to redeem himself just a little.
No, no, no.